No, go ahead. Sorry.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Matt. All right. Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining us. My name is Matthew Roberts. I'm a territory sales rep for Redmond Williams. Today, we've got a webinar going here with Jen, the CEO of CI Web Group, leader in digital marketing and founder of the 12-step roadmap. Like to welcome her today. Like to welcome everybody that's on here with us, and we'll hand it on over to Jennifer.
Fantastic. Matt, what do you think the biggest reason is that people participate in education for their business?
Because I think a lot of people, their business is their baby, and they want to learn more about how to grow that baby, grow that business, and become successful.
Fantastic. Dave, what do you think about digital marketing? Is it something that everybody is born with the skills to be able to manage, or?
Well, yeah. I think in today's world, I think it's actually something a lot of people are lacking, right? And I think it's something that people need to, you know, grow with and adapt and to take a little bit more seriously than kind of we ever have in the past, right? It's the way the future's going, and people need to get on board.
Fantastic. Marcia, what do you do if you need something? You need something for your house, you're trying to find a price, trying to find a product, service.
Go online.
Go online and what?
Search. Google.
Google it.
It's anything like my wife these days. It's all about Amazon, so.
Absolutely. Well, fantastic, you guys. Thank you so, so much for attending. All of you that are attending live, as well as all of you that are watching the recording afterwards. You guys, we're going to get right to it. The internet is better when you own it. This game of being an entrepreneur and being able to grow your business significantly depends on your ability to be present online where people are looking. No difference than if I rewind this tape to 30 years ago when McDonald's was identifying their marketing strategy. They decided to put those arches where the majority of people are. Do you guys know where that is? Any guesses right out of the gate? Where did McDonald's decide to put the arches? Any thoughts? At the end of the freeway exits. At the end of the freeway exits. The highest volume of traffic back then was obviously on the freeway, and that's where they wanted to put it. The idea of marketing is as simple as meet people where they are. Be an option for the services you want to sell in the cities you're willing to sell them to the people looking for them. That's essentially it. So during this process, you guys, we're going to kind of demystify some of the complexities about marketing and put you guys in a position where every single week, every month, you have pieces of information that allow you to make progress. Progress is what creates success over time. A repetitive action done, that's how we learn. So in this environment, you guys, there's no questions that are offline. You guys, you have a control panel somewhere on your screen, and on that control panel there is a chat box. Inside that chat, feel free to share information, ask questions. First thing out of the gate, you guys, all of you that are attending live, do me a favor, drop in your website address inside there and tell us the city in which your business is located. What is the main location of your business? And we'll get started with diving into those in a little bit. Now, that being said, Matt had mentioned the 12-step roadmap to achieve accelerated results. Essentially, this is a system that has been implemented thousands of times and measured as far as results and growth and progress and business overall profits and the company owner's overall goal. And each time that the right things are implemented at the right time in the right order, we're able to show significant success with business owners. My guess is I'd chosen my own business, we didn't decide to dump our corporate job and benefits and regular paycheck and security for a job that has us working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You guys are essentially an entrepreneur. And as an entrepreneur, at some point there was a drive, something inside your heart and soul that said, I can do this better. I want more money. I want more time. I want more freedom. I can do this on my own. And with that, we learned real quick what becoming an entrepreneur means. Doesn't necessarily always produce more time, more money, and more freedom. Typically, it's you investing everything that you have, taking on all the liability and all of the risk, only to work harder and longer. So we need to break that cycle. And we need to go back to the roots of, why did you become an entrepreneur? Because you want more time, money, and freedom. And in order to get that, we have to start thinking about building the business, growing the business as a system. When we implement the right things in the right order, at the right time, we make progress. The challenge is there's so many webinars and information and speakers and clubs and groups and communities and all of these things you can join, and you get pieces of information at each one of them, and they're not necessarily given to you in the right order. So you might go to a webinar where you listen to some tweet, teach you how to tweet, and next thing you know, you should be doing Twitter online to grow your business. And while it's a good activity, it might not be the right activity right now for you. So as you continue to attend these webinars and these training series, Redmond Williams is committed to bringing you guys consistent information and education. Every time you come, another light bulb moment's going to take place. And then if you execute something, decide and choose to make progress, you guys, you're going to see a big difference in your business a year from now. If you decide not to execute, then you'll wish you would have a year from now. So those are both choices, both different paths. That being said, the connection between the 12-step roadmap and each individual element, I wanna make sure that we make some of those connections now. Starting with step one, and you'll notice that there's little feet print on here. The feet print grow and get bigger and bigger and bigger over time. That represents growth. When you're first getting started, one of the very first mistakes that is always made in almost every single business is we take our main business from a digital standpoint and we turn it into a DIY project. We build our own website. We hire a friend, a family member, a felon, somebody that says it's gonna be fast or free, someone from your office, someone that's inexperienced. We hire Bob from his garage to build the site. The challenge is, in a digital space, everything depends on your website and the strength of your website. Is it compliant with Google's requirements? Is it designed for consumer search? Does it work properly on mobile devices? Is it safe and secure? Does it turn people on to working with your business, or does it turn them away? Does it help you get new customers, or does it pull you away from being able to acquire new business? So that being said, we're gonna dive into how your website plays a role in your business. We're gonna dive into how content, which is essentially your voice, plays a role in your website and your ability to do anything else. We'll talk a little bit about conversion systems, local, reviews, social, search, and we'll jump into paid. And we probably will not get to everything on this list. This is a cursory training, so there's lots more training where this came from. Let me just connect these dots. If your website is not secure and you go spend money on search engine optimization, Google will penalize your site and you will lose. You will not rank. You'll be burning through cash. If your website is good, but your SEO is not good, you're not ranking on page one of Google, and you decide you want to go invest in paid advertising, Google AdWords, you're going to pay more money and have less conversions because the domain authority or the reputation score of your website impacts how often Google displays your ads and how much you're going to pay per click. If your website is great, you're on page one of Google, but your reviews are nowhere to be seen or not good, then all of the money you spent on building a great website, great content, getting to page one of Google is all for nothing, because a consumer is gonna search for your company name and they're gonna see that the reviews don't exist or that there are none or that they're all negative and they're out. If your website is great, your SEO is great, your reviews are pretty good, but your social media, the last time you posted content on Facebook was 2016, they think your business is closed. If I come to your website, it's on page one of Google, your reviews and reputation are outstanding, your social media has content that's recent, but it's 2 o'clock in the morning and I'm trying to get emergency repair scheduled, and your local listing says your company is closed and you don't have a way to be able to, they can't hear? No audio? Do you have audio? Okay, so how about
I can hear you fine.
You can, okay. So some cannot hear, so do a mic check. As long as my mic's working, you guys should be good. If you can't hear, check, and Clay, if you can type this to them on the chat as well. Check your computer speakers, make sure those are turned on. And
call in number with ID number just now to everybody.
Perfect. And Kathy also sent the call-in number with the ID. So if you need to call in, so if you don't have speakers that are working on your computer, you can always call in using your cell phone as well. Everyone else good? You got it? All right. And you're going to get a recording, and the recording has all this content. So you'll be able to catch up afterwards. All right, you guys. So you get my drift. Everything is connected. And dependent, interdependent. If one thing is off, the money you spend somewhere else is not as valuable. All right. So before we go too far into this, the trainings like these, because we're going to cover a lot of information, and yes, it's overwhelming, there is training every single week. So you guys can register for those trainings by going to CO Web Group under Education, Training Calendar. Click on Training Calendar, and there is a link in the top left that says pre-register for training. You guys take time today to fill out that form. On there, you'll be able to let us know a little bit of information about your business and what kind of trainings are most important to you. What do you want to learn the most? Then our team will be able to take care of making sure that we get you registered, save you a seat, and get you notified or get you registered into the trainings that are important to you. Again, this is a digital era. You don't have to attend live. You can absolutely register for the training and make sure that you get the recorded copy. So if you're busy, the weather's changing, you guys are swamped, don't worry about that. Just register, and that way you get a copy of the training as well. And it'll take care of any technical issues that you have. It's all good. All right. The complexities of a digital marketing team, and I'm not going to stay on this too long. The average customer that we have and are working on their website and a marketing project for them, on average, we have between 20 and 30 different resources that are working on different elements. When I said you hire the guy named Bob, you guys, it's impossible for Bob to do all of this. If you're trying to rely on an office manager or someone in your office to be able to provide all of the technical expertise that are necessary, you guys, it's almost impossible. A web team. For anybody that knows a coder or a developer, you guys, they've been coding. Their garage is an office space. They've code in and program in something that looks more like the Matrix, black screen with green text. If you know someone who's a designer, they dress nice. They have real friends. Their garage is for cars. I mean, it's a different kind of human. And someone that knows database architecture, they think in bullet points and graphs and charts and databases and hierarchies, and they know object-oriented programming, entirely different. Content writers, editors, you know, the person who is great at content or the one that checks your spelling every time you do something, that's a different kind of human. A coder, they can't spell much because all they do is write in code. They know PHP and JavaScript and so forth. All of these different team members, from a social media team, local, web maintenance, server maintenance, video, conversion rate optimization, pay-per-click, SEO, you guys, they're all different people, and you technically need a small percentage of each one of these kinds of resources to be able to continue to grow the business. Why are all of these different resources important at different times? Because when you're first getting started on getting your company in front of humans who are looking for the services you want to sell, you're starting with the infrastructure at the bottom. When you're first getting your website online, that is an infrastructure piece. You can't build a website and all of a sudden it's on page one of Google, you're number one. You can't design a site, pop it up, and all of a sudden your phone's gonna ring. There's a process to this. So if you think about the internet like an iceberg, when you first launch a website, your website is not available to people at all. It's not presented by Google. You technically work for your website, it doesn't work for you. In the infrastructure phase, you're building the elements that are necessary in order to be able to get your company's name in front of people who are looking for it. Your website, your content, making sure your Google business listing is set up, you're on local directories, your social media accounts are set up, getting your Gmail or your G Suite account. The infrastructure is a lot of investments in technology and infrastructure that don't necessarily make you money. And this is a hard pill to swallow in a lot of instances. From an infrastructure standpoint, next, you gotta have a voice. I'm sure everyone's heard the term content is king, or content is required. Without content, you're not speaking, you're not talking. So in this instance, if you don't have someone that is producing content on a regular basis, technically it's like you not talking. If you try and sell a lot of products and services without speaking, that's gonna be a little bit tough. Well, the digital space is identical. If you don't have content being published to each of the different infrastructure pieces or mediums or kind of vehicles to transport your company to people searching, then it doesn't, there's nothing for Google to file. There's nothing for people to hear or read. Next is marketing. Once you have the infrastructure in place, your content's in place, there's got to be a marketing plan that is completely focused on being able to build the reputation of your business, to enhance your website's ranking on Google, to enhance your local directories, to make sure your Google business listing gets to the top, to ensure that your social media accounts start being showcased and visible as an option. All of these three elements are going to essentially be the backbone of you improving your visibility, continuing to grow your overall business's rankings online, which essentially means that you're gonna actually be an option to those people searching for the services you wanna sell in the cities that you're willing to serve. When a consumer searches on Google, you only have five ways to be an option. There are just five. First is, and I'm putting in order of the search engine, not in order of opportunity. Because the interesting part is the order of opportunity, there's actually a higher volume of opportunity lower down in the page than there is at the very top. So first is Google Local Services. If you put on your checklist, one of the items is make sure you're getting signed up for Google Local Service Ads. That is an advertising option on Google that allows you to get found in the very top listings, and it's a pay per call. You only pay when somebody places a call. And you can dispute those that are sales calls and so forth. Next is Google AdWords, also known as pay-per-click. The third is completely free, which is your Google business listing, making sure that you're set up on Google Maps, that you're properly categorized, and that you're building the highest volume of reviews and content on your Google business listing is going to give you a broader reach inside the city that your business is located, not outside of there. That primarily helps you grow your business in the physical city that your company is located. The fourth element is Google SEO, or organic placement, organic results. That's everything below the maps. So you guys think for just a second, when you're online and you're doing a search as mom or dad or husband or wife or homeowner, you go to Google and you do a search, how many of you click on the ads? How many of you click on the maps? And how often do you click in the top three listings on Google? I can take any audience, a room full of 1,000 or 5,000 or 100, and I'm going to have 99% of the entire audience say that they will definitely click on the maps and And priority is always going to be, they're going to click on page one of Google in the top three. And if they go to page two, they got to be really desperate. Something went wrong. I believe I read a meme earlier that says where to hide dead bodies, and it said page two of Google. Essentially, if you're not listed on page one of Google, the ability to get found doesn't exist. And then the fifth option is you can use other people's sites or third-party websites to also get into the organic rankings and placement on page one of Google. You can do that through review sites, social media, local directories, maps, and citation sites. The broader your scale of participation in each one of these areas, the higher the opportunity value of people actually laying their eyes on your company to see you as an option. So to summarize this piece, the easiest way to think of this is your website is a store. Okay, that's your retail store today. That's your McDonald's sign. The content inside your website is the products and services that you make available for Google to be able to present to people who are looking for those products and services. So if someone is looking for AC repair in blank, whatever the city is, if you don't have a page that says AC repair in blank, there's nothing for Google to file. There's nothing for people to see. So you cannot market something that does not exist. Most of the time when we dive into someone's digital marketing kind of world, what we notice is they got a website, they jumped in and started marketing, and they forgot to build all the products and services inside their store. They forgot to make a list of what do we want to sell, where do we want to sell it, and do we have those products and services properly installed inside our store so Google can start filing those services for people to be able to find. You see, success is simple when you focus on high leverage activities, when you focus on doing the right things in the right order at the right time. There are two different kinds of shoppers. There's more than that, but there's two primaries. You have those who have an urgent need. Something's broke, which is the majority of consumers. And you have those who like to do research. They're proactive. They're going to go check things out, do their research before they actually have a problem, which you're talking about 20% of human population is that proactive. And that might be an overestimate. So the majority of reasons why people are going to start searching is because they need something. Something's broke. They're sitting in a dire situation. So if you guys are positioned so that that person who's in a dire position can find you online, then you now have an opportunity to present your products and services. So my first question would be, you guys go do some searches. Take the combination. What do I want to sell? AC repair. Where do I want to sell it? Pick a city and do that search. Do you show up on page one of Google, and how many times do you show up? The answer is either yes or no. If you do not show up on page one of Google for that combination, you cannot sell that service digitally. You can't get found for something that doesn't exist. Emergency AC repair in city, do you show up? Emergency air conditioner repair, AC repair company in city. You guys start doing those searches to see if your company is an option on page one of Google. And if you're not, let's fix it. There's no reason. Right now, the weather's changing, obviously. You guys, business is not impacted by, in your world, by the pandemic or anything else. Business is impacted by the weather. And there's no flu that's gonna cause the weather to change, right? The weather, it's gonna get hot, it's gonna be cold. And we need to make sure that your company is an option on page one of Google where people are looking when they need help. You see, what happens when they need help and they go to Google and they do a search, they will type in something like AC repair in blank. You guys fill in the city, any city or town. What they won't fill in is AC repair in zip code. That's a print advertising company. If somebody's talking to you about zip codes, they probably had issues in the print or traditional advertising world and moved into digital marketing and you know, didn't get that training that said, we don't talk about zip codes in the digital space. Okay, so when somebody does a search, essentially what happens is Google's drawer flies open, and inside that drawer, there is a specific number of pages that show in that drawer. The number of pages in that drawer for that combination, AC repair in blank, that is your competition. It's not the guys in the chamber. It's not the guys whose businesses that you know. In a digital space, you have to be in the top 10 of whatever that number is. Any number. That is your competition. The smaller the number of pages in the drawer, the faster you can get to page one of Google and get ranked. The bigger the number of pages in the drawer, the harder you have to work and the longer it's going to take before you see any kind of return on your investment to get ranked for that service. So knowing the combinations that you want to get found for is important because a different drawer opens up every time. You guys, real quick, drop in the chat. Let me see if I can grab your chat area. Drop in the chat some cities that you guys want to get found in. And let's go to Google and actually do those searches now. Now you guys have been busy up in here, right? Nice. Okay. Perfect. Sean, thank you so much. So we're going to go AC. So glad I didn't have to try and spell that online in front of all of you. All right. Just saying. So, you guys, drop in additional cities. Pick any city you guys that's important to you, and we're going to go check these out. So, just like I just showed you in the video, when I search for AC repair in not Mississippi, but Mississauga. Wow. I'm going to need help with that one.
Mississauga.
Thank you. All I see is Mississippi. So, in Mississauga, there are 10,400,000 competitive pages in this drawer. So if your goal is to sell air conditioning repair in Mississauga, then you here are your options. This is what I was showing you earlier. You can get into Google Guarantee, which is a Google local service ad. You can pay per click through Google Ads. If you have the highest number of reviews, well, let me back up. If you have a physical office in Mississauga that's been verified on Google and you have the most and the best reviews with the most frequent content being published, then you would have the ability to get found inside the Google My Business or Google Maps area, or you've got to go after search engine optimization. You've got to get ranked in the organic areas, in the top 10, preferably in the top 3. 10 million is a lot of competition. So I want you to see how this changes. So if I want to get found for AC repair in Mississauga, I need to have a page. Okay, let me try and fix the sound system for you. Hold tight. We're just going to try and fix this right now and see if we can get the audio changed out. Okay, I'm going to do a test. You guys tell me, did the audio improve? Use the chat. Test. Audio, can you hear me? Is that better? Matt, good. Improved audio? Okay. Audio is very bad still. So I've got one more. Okay, so we got a bunch that say they have, we're good to go. So if you're having audio issues, try calling in. And then if you have issues with audio, let me know and I'll switch. I've got 3 microphones that we're good. Okay, All right, so if I want to get found for AC repair in Mississauga, Mississauga, I have to, I love that I do these publicly, I have to ensure that I have a page on my website that specifically is titled and has content completely repaired to this. If I want to change this to air conditioner, I want you to notice that Google is going to open up a different drawer. So remember that file system when I said your competition is the total number of pages in that drawer. So if this is what I want to get found for, there are 791,000 pages in this drawer. That is significantly better than going after the 10.4 million. Now, the total number of searches might be lower for air conditioner repair than AC repair. I don't know what that is. I'd have to go look at that to see what the total number of people searching for air conditioner repair versus AC repair in this particular city is. But here's what I can tell you. 100% of nothing is nothing. If you don't rank because you're competing with 10.4 million pages, then there's nothing you can sell. So sometimes it's better to go after a smaller city that has less opportunity because there's less competitive pages. You can get ranked on page one faster and you can start making money and go after some of the more difficult searches outside of that. So you guys, I'm gonna go back. Let me see. I know you put in additional cities. Okay, got it. So let's go change this to Concord. A new drawer opens up, 10.2 million. And you guys tell me, Huntersville, Highland Creek, Mount Pleasant, I see some other areas in this. Are these communities that would show up on someone's address or would be a good opportunity? Kingston, perfect, thank you. And we're gonna go look at these, the competition. So that's technically a pretty high competition search term. I'm gonna look for AC repair in Concord. Again, high competition, 10.9 million. I want you to watch, and you guys tell me in the chat, do you sell ductless systems? And this is why I'm showing you. Okay, in every search term, there are opportunities that have low amounts of competition that allow you to get in like Flynn and start making cash earlier because the number of pages competing in that bucket is much, much smaller. Most HVAC companies have barely the number of pages that they need to represent the actual services. In fact, 9 out of 10 HVAC companies that I go look at are missing the main services they want to sell on their websites, AC repair. And you guys tell me if these are services you want to sell. AC repair, AC installation, AC service, AC replacement, AC maintenance, AC inspection. Why would I want to sell AC inspections? Because all of the people who are working with a realtor to buy a house got an inspector to do an inspection and somebody said you got to get an AC inspection before we'll clear the condition to close. Emergency AC repair. Weekend AC repair. Okay. All of these different search terms or services create a different opportunity value for you. Some of them have a smarter, or some of them, it is easier to get ranked using search engine optimization as your primary strategy, i.e. content writing, link building, on-page SEO, like this one. If you want to get ranked for ductless AC repair in Concord, game on. That'll take us about 30 days after we go live, as long as you're meeting the minimum kind of requirements for having a website that's compliant and secure and so forth. If you change this, so we just went to Kingston, you'll notice there's only 101,000 pages in this drawer. As we switch each one of these, the drawer is going to open up with a different number of competitive pages. So there's 682,000. And you'll notice that there's probably a lot more opportunity because you're seeing a lot more ads show up. So for ductless AC repair, or we'll change it to ductless AC installation, there's 159,000 pages in this drawer. That means the competition is very low. There are companies that are using their Google Guarantee or their Google Local Business ads, their service ads, to get ranked for ductless air conditioning related services and installation. We do see ads on the page, so there are people that are willing to pay per click to get listed or to get a lead from an ad. Obviously, we've got Google Maps, those who specialize in ductless. And then as we go into the organic rankings, you're gonna have 10 opportunities. There's only 159 pages in here. Let me show you some examples. I'm gonna go over to one of our clients and show you some actual real life examples so we can go through. Every single service you wanna sell technically needs a page on it. So emergency air conditioner repair, think of it like a grocery store. I wanna sell emergency air conditioner repair services in Gulf, Ontario. So I'm gonna create that product. I'm gonna put it in the store and make it available in Gulf, Ontario. There are 1.4 million pages in this drawer. They are not choosing to use Google Guarantee. They are not choosing to pay per call. They're not, actually they are ranking inside the Google business listing. So there's the first opportunity for them to get the impression or the conversion. And here's the second opportunity for them to get the conversion. You'll notice exactly what the consumer is searching for is exactly what the title of the page is. The more popular this page becomes, the higher it ranks on Google, the more impressions, the more views, the more clicks, then you just gotta close them. All you gotta do is get in front of human eyeballs that are looking for the things you guys wanna sell. Fantastic. So on your website, this is the way to audit it. This is a very simple way to audit it. Start at the top, work your way down. So grab the page title. That's like the label on the ketchup bottle. Paste it in Google. First ask yourself, is this something I want to be found for? Do I want to get found for air conditioning services? Is this where I want to get found? Glance at the number of competitive pages and then choose, these are my opportunities. I can pay per call, I can pay per click, I can show up in the organic ranking, or I can show up on the maps, or I can go after getting ranked in the organic rankings down here. In order to get that page to rank, that's what marketing does. The higher this crawls, the higher this climbs inside Google, the more opportunity. So this particular page, this single page, is number 7 of 1 million pages. Pretty good, not the best. The best is number 1. So we have to consistently be working towards, how do we get that page? What do I wanna sell? Air conditioner installation. Where do I wanna sell it? Choose your primary location. Do the search. This has significantly more competition. This is a high competition search phrase, which means either A, it's gonna take you longer to make any money and get ranked organically, or B, you might need to pay for an ad or a call in order to show up here. So for this one, 9.3 million, they're showing up in the organic rankings for their Google Maps, which is fantastic. Let's go check on their site. And they just made it onto page 1. They are currently sitting at number 10 of 9.3 million other pages. This is technically your audit. So one of your audits is make a list of what do I wanna sell. So I'm gonna show you how to go make that list and make it really easy. If you go to HVAC marketing websites, which Kathy will put this in the chat, or Clay, there is a button at the very top that says onboarding. This is a list of search phrases, keywords, that is technically the audit tool for you guys to determine what do I want to sell compared to what consumers are looking for. So if you go here and you fill this form out, all you're doing is checking boxes to determine what do you want to sell. So do you sell, wine cellar air conditioning, basement air conditioning service, garage air conditioning service. The reason I'm going to, let me just show you that. We'll just take this one. If somebody's searching for garage air conditioning in Snohomish, Washington, our client has a page specifically for garage air conditioning services in Snohomish, Washington, so that they can be an option for that particular service. And they have unlimited lead opportunities because the page is an organic or SEO related page instead of pay-per-click or pay-per-call. If you guys are spending money on pay-per-click and pay-per-call, you're essentially burning through cash. And that should be used very sparingly and very carefully. Ideally, you want to identify, what do I want to sell? Where do I want to sell it? Do I have a page for it on my website? And is that page on page one of Google? So if I want to install air conditioning systems in garages, great. Let's go houseboat heater installation. We'll go to Seattle for this one. There's 5.9 million pages in the drawer. And you'll notice here, we're going after marine heating and air conditioning, houseboats, lakefront, vessels, waterfront, in all of these different cities. We're focused on generating leads and opportunities in this. This came because there was a giant snowstorm in Seattle and they weren't used to it. So everyone that lived on a floating home or a houseboat lost all of their heat. And so our client, First Response, Braxton and the guys said, yeah, we're willing to take care of them. You have to get creative too. Right now, in the Seattle area, one of the other things we're doing for Braxton specifically is he's learned from targeting a new niche industry, the floating home industry, that they have another need. They need propane delivery. They need fuel delivery. They need gas delivery. So he now has an entire another operation that allows him to focus on taking those guys and having them do delivery out to those docks. And that's a monthly recurring revenue that he didn't have before. So every one of the things you put on your website, for example, these are AC rentals, which these guys do a great job with their rental programs. Here's another page for air conditioning rentals. So think out of the box. First, take care of the basics, your main air conditioning related pages, your main furnace related, heater related pages. Dive into the IAQ, what do you wanna sell? Then we need to drill into where do you wanna sell it, making sure that you have each city that you want to service has to be listed on your website with content. And so this is gonna take a while, you guys. It's not a, it doesn't happen overnight. Every time you want to expand and build, it's just a matter of identifying what do I wanna sell, where do I wanna sell it, building in those pages, and then continuing to grow from there. Same thing with improving the pages. When you first start off with your website, you're gonna have a bunch of pages that have really, technically they're kind of crummy. They have limited content. They may only have a picture or an image. They don't have great text. They're not designed to convert. So building a website, when you think about it, it's not a project, it's a lifestyle. So when they first launched their maintenance plan page, the maintenance plan said, we have a maintenance plan, sign up if you're interested. It didn't have any details in there. It didn't go into anything. And this is gonna continue to improve and grow, and it'll move eventually to where people can put in a credit card, pay online, sign up online and so forth. So every single page on your site becomes more effective, more efficient, helps you get found more frequently, and eventually helps you close more business. How's the audio, you guys? Let me just glance at the chat. Can you still hear me? All right, good deal. All right, so let's fly through some of this. There are opportunities that essentially need to be uncovered for each one of you. For each one of the primary search terms and each one of the primary locations, we need to figure out what is a service that you can get ranked for quickly. get your phone ringing. You guys get into the home, work your magic, and or get on a call or get on a virtual sales call and work your magic, and you guys can bring other things to the table. This is a company out of New York that we worked with and found a niche in his area, which was oil gas conversion. So we focused on building pages that were oil gas conversions in Beacon and Poughkeepsie and Fishkill and all of these different cities, brought him to page one of Google for every one of those search terms where he owned page one, position one, two, sometimes one, two, and three. And that became a great lead source for other more competitive search terms that were out there as well. So Daddy, I want it now. You guys, it's a process. This is a lifestyle. Every time you show up for one of these trainings, every time you show up on a strategy call with your marketing company, your mindset essentially needs to be, what are we doing that's working? Let's quickly go over that. If you build a page of content and they optimize it and make it popular, get it ranked on page one of Google, and all of a sudden you're selling a new service, you're getting calls for a new service in a new area, that's working, do more. Get more pages added to your site, do more optimization and make those pages popular and get them to rank. Do more of what's working. Secondly, figure out what's not working. If you're burning through cash on pay-per-click and there's no permanent value, if you're burning through ads, if you're doing traditional media advertising, print, and you guys see the cash going out the window and the hopes and the promises that it's gonna eventually turn in and you know better, we have to stop doing. Stop, stop, stop. And the third one is in order to grow, we have to have a mindset that says what's next. What are we not doing yet that we should do? Pull out the 12-step roadmap, sit down and have a strategy set conversation with Clay or TM and go through and go, all right, what's next? How am I positioned on Google? Can I get positioned for more services or in more areas? Am I ranking? Are the pages converting? Because improvement, everything you improve, once you get a page to page one of Google, that page becomes more important to look better. So it's almost like you create your first product in a little farmer's market and you put it out there and you kind of did some DIY labels and it sells a little bit, but then all of a sudden it gets picked up by Walmart. All of a sudden you might want to improve the branding of that product. You might want to improve the way that it looks, what it does, the information, the guidelines, the how to use it, the description. That's the same thing with your website is. Once you are an option on page one of Google, make that page work for you. More content, get some pictures on there, get some video on there, get some case studies, some before and after photos, really build that page up. Because remember, your website is either selling or not selling for you. It's selling something, good or bad, for you way before you ever get a chance to talk to that client, way before you ever get a chance to talk to them. So the down and dirty, get your website up, get the content as much as you can up and get it on page one of Google, start with that. But then go back to those pages and continue to improve them, add more to them, get those things to start helping you sell more. I'm gonna skip this and we're gonna move here. Very quick, pay-per-click and SEO, this is not one or the other. And I mentioned this a little bit earlier. If your SEO, search engine optimization, if your website has a low page rank, low domain authority, then your pay-per-click plan, because you want the McDonald's drive-through easy button, you want your phone to ring, leads to come in, your pay-per-click is gonna have less results and cost you more money per click. Because Google gives preferential treatment to those websites who have a higher domain authority. So it's not one or the other. Technically, they're interdependent. Search engine optimization is easier when you're doing pay-per-click. And pay-per-click performs better when your SEO works. So technically, it's just a matter of starting with your strong infrastructure and then using pay-per-click for what it's designed for. It's designed when you have extra cash flow, you're trying to fill holes in your schedule during a demand season or during shoulder season, you're trying to have a big promotion or you're trying to get a lot more of something specific for a shorter period of time, That's what pay-per-click is for. Other than that, everything you do should be infrastructure, infrastructure. The difference when you're looking at your cash as an entrepreneur, when you spend money on traditional advertising, you're burning through cash. And when that cash runs out, when the campaign is over, when you're out of money, you're literally exactly where you started when you turn the campaign on. When you focus on investing in digital marketing assets that are permanent, they have a compounding interest impact on your business. The dollar you spend today is actually worth more in the future. A page that's been around since 2016 is more powerful than a page that just got launched in 2020 or right now, depending on when you're watching this. So the longer a digital asset exists, the more powerful it becomes, which is, again, why not to wait. I'm going to skip this. This is kind of the nuts and bolts, is this math that you dive into. Is, are you an option for what you want to sell, where you want to sell it? So figure out, what do you want to sell, and go look. If the answer is no, I'm not on page one, then we got some work to do. We need to get that website fixed, get you compliant with Google, make sure this properly designed and developed. If it's old, if it's not compliant, if it's insecure, there's 101 things that can happen with the website that will cause the website, no matter how much money or time you put into it, not to rank online. Websites don't last forever. They last for 18 to 24 months. So if you're not showing up on Google, if you do this audit and you go, oh my gosh, okay, well, no wonder I have a hard time right now. It's because I'm not an option to anybody who's looking. Then we need to fix that. If you are an option on page one of Google, A, we need to make sure you stay there. B, we need to make sure that when a consumer lands on that page, that they're taking action, they're converting. Do you have a great promotion? Do you have a great call to action? Can they chat with you any time of the night? Can they schedule online? So if you were seen, were they interested? And can they click through or can they not? Do they leave because the website didn't pull up right on their phone, or because there was no way to contact you in the middle of the night, or there's no online chat option? Anything that they're interested in converting with, if you don't have it available, it's possible they leave. Your bounce rate. If they don't find what they're looking for, or the website scares them, or there's a giant flag that says, wait, don't fill out any info, site's not secure, then that's going to increase your bounce rate. The higher your bounce rate, the more Google doesn't trust you either. So Google and consumers, if they don't trust your site, they're going to be out of there. And your conversion rate, how many of them do you actually wind up contacting you? Do you allow them to text? Do you allow them to click to call? Do you allow them to schedule online? Do you allow them to chat? Can they connect with you on your social media sites? Let the consumer do whatever they're used to, whatever is important to them. And then more of those options you make available, the more you're going to have a chance to close. You guys, the more of these pieces, the 12-step roadmap that you put in place, the higher number of opportunities you're going to have. If each one of these dots represents an opportunity, a potential, somebody that actually saw your company and gets to go through the process of making a decision, the more of the 12-step roadmap elements you have in place, the bigger this pie is going to be, because you're always going to have some people that are detractors. They bounce, they leave. But we need to make sure that you have the highest volume of opportunities that's commonly possible in your area, that you are an option for on page one of Google. And I know we have 2 minutes left, so let me give you, we're going to skip 90% of this presentation, and we're going to move to the helpline. You guys, I want to make it really easy for you guys to get help. So first, grab your cell phone and go to your text messages and type in the number 877-839-1122. And just type the word help. What's going to happen is our system's going to send you an email that's going to give you, or a text message that's going to give you a link to pre-register for future trainings. So everyone at Redmond Williams is committed to hosting these, and I'm going to have you guys talk a little bit. I think Mauricio or Matt, who's going to wrap this up. You guys get registered for these trainings, and I think we have another one next week, and we'll rock and roll from there. Matt.
Yeah. Yeah, I think Dave was going to say a couple words to wrap us up here, but definitely thank you for this. It is, I keep learning a little bit more every time, and it's invaluable, like I said earlier. So thank you very much.
Yeah, I just wanted to come on and just say, thank you for everything. This is a great opportunity for our dealers. We have another one coming up on the 27th. Jennifer, the one on the 27th is going to be basically a repeat of today, right?
I'm not very good at repeating. Well. So it'll be, yes, I missed about
I have three kids and you have to repeat all sorts of stuff.
So, I missed about half of this presentation. So what I'll do for next time is I'll make sure and get to the second half that I missed in this one. So if you attended this, definitely come back to the next one. No matter what, the more you hear this kind of strategy, the more different you're going to think about your business and the different actions you'll be able to take. You'll get better results.
Yes, for sure. Okay, that's great. So for anybody who's registered today and is on today, please feel free to get on for the next one as well. And any future ones, as we will be definitely hosting more and more of these as time goes on and as our world and our economy gets back into some normalcy. Just little tools like this will kind of help you gain that much more traction than the other guy.
Absolutely.
So thank you very much, Jennifer. Thank you, Clay. Thank you, everybody, for being on board and helping us out. And if there's any questions, feel free to contact any one of us.
Appreciate you, Dave, Matt, Marcio. Guys, have a great one. We'll see you next week.
Okay. Thanks, guys.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Thanks, everyone. We'll see you next
week. All right. Take care.
Thank you again.